My young friends, this man was so great that even the enemies of Allah and his Rasul acknowledged the greatness of Khalid bin Waleed radiallahu ta'ala an. He was a man so great, my young friends, that many from amongst the enemies of Allah and his Rasul actually believed that this man actually carries the sword of Allah, and it is with this sword of Allah this man destroys the enemies of Allah and his Rasul. Battle of Yarmuk, and a senior Roman commander by the name of Jarja, he wants to meet Khalid bin Waleed. He makes his way to Khalid and he says to Khalid, "Oh Khalid, I want you to tell me the truth. Do not lie to me, as a free man does not lie." And he asked, "Oh Khalid, I beg you, tell me the truth. Did Allah send a sword from the heavens and give to your Nabi? And did your Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in turn give you this sword, as a result of which you defeat and destroy your enemy whenever you meet them in battle?" And Khalid bin Waleed radiallahu ta'ala replied in the negative. And he told him as to why he was called the sword of Allah. And this had such an impact on the heart of Jarja, the honesty of Khalid bin Waleed, that there and then Jarja's next question, "Oh Khalid, tell me, what do you invite towards?" And Khalid said, "I invite towards the worship of the one Allah, the Lord of the Arsh and Kursi, my creator, your creator. I invite towards Iman, Islam. I invite towards Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as being the last and final messenger." Jarja asked, "Oh Khalid, tell me, if somebody were to embrace your religion and declare the kalima la ilaha illallah, what would his maqam and status be in your religion?" Look at the wisdom. Khalid bin Waleed responds, "Oh Jarja, my deen is so beautiful that in my deen, everyone is equal. The black, the white, the Arab, the non-Arab, the poor man, the rich man. In my deen, when it comes to the teachings of Allah and his Rasul, and when it comes to showing obedience to Allah and his Rasul, we are all equal. The black one, the white one, the high one, the low one. When the poor has to bow down and prostrate before his creator, then the king living in his palace has to bow down and prostrate before his creator. When the poor man has to fast, then the king has to fast. When the poor man has to do good, then the rich man has to do good. This is the maqam and status of everyone in our deen." His final question, "O Khalid, tell me, هل لمن يدخل في الإسلام اليوم مثل ما لكم من المثوبة والأجر?" If somebody were to declare the kalima and embrace your deen, would he receive the same reward as you receive? Khalid said, "Indeed, بلكي أفضل." He will receive more reward. Jarja asked, "How can that be? How can you receive more reward when you declared the kalima before him?" Look at the wisdom of Khalid bin Waleed. The reason he will receive more reward than us is because we saw the Nabi of Allah with our own eyes. We met the Nabi of Allah. We were able to speak to the Nabi of Allah. We were able to question him. And the Nabi of Allah would quench our thirst by answering our objections. And then with our eyes, we saw the miracles of Allah. Whereas you people have not seen Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You did not meet the messenger. You were not able to speak to him and question him. And you did not see the miracles of Allah. But still you people declare the kalima, "La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah." This is why you will receive more reward than we receive. Such was the impact of Khalid bin Waleed on this senior Roman commander in the Battle of Yarmouk, that had come to kill Khalid bin Waleed and the believers, that on the battlefield he declares that, "I testify there is no God worthy of worship but Allah, and truly Muhammad is the messenger of Allah." And on the battlefield now, Khalid leads Jarja in prayer. This man has never prayed before. He doesn't know how to pray. Khalid bin Waleed says, Allahu Akbar. Jarja says, Allahu Akbar. Khalid bin Waleed goes into ruku. Jarja goes into ruku. Khalid bin Waleed goes into sajda. Jarja goes into sajda. This was his first prayer, and this was his last prayer. Because after this prayer, such was the impact of Khalid bin Waleed on the senior Roman general, that after the prayer, he rides alongside Khalid bin Waleed, heading towards the very same people that he just come from. This time, to elevate the kalima, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. And he fights against these very people alongside Khalid bin Waleed, only to Allah to elevate him and to accept him for shahada. And Jarja leaves the world having offered only one prayer.